Hello dear students, and once again welcome back to this online class video. This is the fourth part of 12th chapter Smart Charts of class 5 subject mathematics, and I am Jay Prakash. Let's start the class. Now come to today's topic. It is family tree. So Madhav went to a wedding along with his parents. He met many relatives there, but he did not know everyone. Yes, it may be happened with everyone that when we go on a wedding function and met our elders relative, so at that situation we were just unable to identify them, that what is the relationship between them and us. Yeah, it happens with everyone. Now he met his mother's grandfather, but found her grandmother is not alive. Means her mother's grandfather is alive, but grandmother is not alive. Means she is dead. He also found that her dadi's mother, means grandmother's mother, is still alive, and she is more than 100 years old. More than. So yes, it's a very confusing relation. So through a family tree with symbols, let's clear it. So first I have to make Madhav. So let me write MM for Madhav. Clear? Now make their parents. So this is father and mother of Madhav. Now one more generation I have to make from his mother's side, not from father's side. So Madhav's mother's father and mother. Clear? This is the main person now, Madhav's mother, and these are their parents. Now once again here we have to make her mother's grandfather. So means her father's father, father, and it will be mother. Okay, so Madhav's mother's grandfather is still alive, but grandmother is not alive. She is dead. Okay, and who was alive? Her dadi's mother. Means one more generation here we have to make. Father and mother, means I can write here M for her mother. Okay, and father. So now let me write the generations. This is first, second, third, fourth, and this is fifth. So we can say that her his mother's grandparents were from fourth generation, and Madhav's mother's grandmother's mother was from fifth generation. So it was such a very long gap of the generations, for that it was very confusing. Now come to the topic. Here, to clear the confusion, what happened? Her mother helped him to understand this relation through a family tree. So here is the family tree. So let's understand this family tree first. In the first generation, here is Madhav. In second generation, his parents, Madhav's father and mother. Now in third generation, which is said grandparents, Madhav's grandparents are here, two grandparents. And now in fourth generation, which is said as great grandparents, how many persons are here? Four persons. And in fifth generation, which is said great-great grandparents, here are eight persons. So now let's continue it. Madhav's mother helped him understand her family with the help of this drawing. You can also find out about your older generations using such family tree. Yes, you can also try yourself by making your own family tree from mother's side. Remember that. Now let's answer some questions. First question is, how many grandparents in all does Shobhana have? Shobhana. So who is Shobhana? Shobhana is Madhav's mother. So here is Shobhana, Madhav's mother. And how many grandparents? So these are Shobhana's parents and these are grandparents. So we can see four grandparents are here. So we can answer here that Shobhana have four grandparents. Now second is, how many great great grandparents in all does Madhav have? So here we have to find Madhav's great-great-grandparents. So here are the great-great-grandparents, means from the fifth generations. And here we can see that total 8 elders are here in great-great-grandparents. That was from fifth generation. Now, third is, how many elders will be in seventh generation of his family, means Madhav's family. So let's try to understand it. Here in first generation only Madhav is here. Okay, so let me write it here. One generation, only one. In second generation, how many persons are here? Two. So let me write two here. In third generation, this is the third generation, here are also two persons. So let me write here two. In fourth generation, how many persons are here? 1, 2, 3, and 4. So write 4. In fifth generation, here are total 8 persons, right? So in sixth generation, how many persons will be there? So to understand this, just look at here from the third generation. You can see the number of persons in third generation were 2. Number of in fourth generation, number of people were 4. Then in fifth generation, total 8 persons there were. So you can see one pattern is here. Okay, that when we go on upper generations, means previous generations, so that was just the double of previous generation. So you can see that here is 4. So 4 was just double of 2, then 8. 8 was just double of 4, right? So when we go on 6th generation, how it will be? Yeah, it will be 16, means double of 18. Similarly, in 7th generation, how many persons will be there? Double of 16, it means 32, right? Similarly, in 8th generation, how many persons will be there? Double of 32. So how much it is? 64, right? And in 9th generation, how many persons will be there? Just a double of 64. So what is this? It is 128. 2, 4, 8 and 2, 6, 12. 128 elders will be in 9th generation. So now come to some more questions. Third question was, how many elders will be in the 7th generation? So that was 32. And if he takes his family tree forward, so in which generation will he find 128 elders? So we found it was in 9th generation. So now one question I want to ask you, so that how many elders or how many persons will be there in 10th generation? If you know the answer, then must comment it. Now in this way we have completed this topic, family tree. I hope that you have very well understand it. So now it's time to say goodbye. So see you all in the next video. Till then, be safe, be healthy. Jai Hind.